Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and in this video I'll be showing you how to create this burst animation effect in PowerPoint 2016. Let's have a look what we will be creating today. So this is an amazing animation technique to reveal your product intros or to highlight some important image in your presentation. So let's quickly start with the tutorial. Before beginning, there are some important points which you need to take care while applying this animation effect. First, this animation can work with the images in portrait mode as well as in landscape mode. But I have used the images in landscape mode only, whereas you can also use an image in portrait form. And second thing is that you need to download this reference PPT so that you have an idea of this animation effect. I'll be providing the link of this reference PPT file in the YouTube show notes below. So open your PowerPoint slide and insert your desired image on which you want to apply this effect. Duplicate this image to make two copies of the same image. If your image is in landscape form, then you need to crop the duplicate copy and make the image vertical like this so that it fits in the cylinder shape. Else, if your image dimensions are already in a portrait form, you can work with it as it is. After cropping the image, right-click the image, choose Save Picture As, and save the image on your system. Then you can delete this duplicate image. Now go to Insert tab, hit the Shapes button and choose the cylinder shape from the drop-down menu. Click and drag the mouse button to insert the shape. Now right-click this shape, click on Format Picture, choose the first option Fill, then Picture or Texture Fill, and then Insert Picture from File. Now browse for the same picture which you had just cropped and saved it in your system, and the image gets inserted in the cylinder. So this was the reason I had made you crop the image from the landscape form to the portrait form so that it fits well in the cylindrical shape. Select the shape, go to the Format tab and remove the border outline of the shape as shown. The last element left in a slide is this 3D square shape. This is an optional element, but it gives the animation a more dynamic look. You can just copy this element from the reference PPT, the link of which has been given in the description box below. Now we need to arrange all the elements. So first arrange the cylinder shape in ratio of the actual image. Make it smaller than the actual image. Then place the 3D square element just below the cylinder. This element has been divided into two parts. So if you just reduce or increase its size, you need to select both the parts and change the size in same proportion, and then you need to align both the parts to make it a complete square. You can also change its color in the Format tab. Now select the front part of this element, right click and select Bring to Front. Similarly, select the second part of this element, right click and choose Send to Back. And now you can see that I can pass my cylinder through this element, and it gives a real look as if the cylinder is coming from within this element. Once we have arranged all the elements in the slide, now it's time to begin with the animation process. First of all, select both the parts of the 3D square element, go to Animation tab, and then Add Animation. Add any desired entrance effect. I will add the spinner effect and click OK. Open the animations pane, right click the effect and open the effect options. Under the timings tab, select start with previous and set the duration of animation to 0.5 seconds. Then select the cylinder and add fly in entrance effect to it. Open the effect options, select start after previous and set the duration to 1 second. Then again select the cylinder and add grow or shrink animation effect to it. Open the effect options and set the size to huge, that is 400%. Under the timings tab, select start after previous and set the duration to 2 seconds. And now, again select the cylinder, go to add animation, open more exit effects and add dissolve out effect to it. Open the effect options, select start with previous and set the duration to 1 second. Now select the original image and add fade entrance effect to it. Under the timings tab, select start with previous and add a delay of 0.3 seconds. Set the duration of animation to 1 second and click OK. Now select both the parts of the 3D square element and add init exit effect to it. I will add the peek out effect. You can see that both the animation effects are selected together in the animations pane. Right click these effects and open the effect options. Under the timings tab, select start with previous and add a delay of 0.7 seconds. Also, set the duration of animation to 0.5 seconds and click OK. Finally, you can also add any text heading to your slide if you want. Add any desired entrance effect to it. I will add the float up entrance effect. Open the effect options, select start with previous and add a delay of 0.7 seconds and set the duration of animation to 1 second. Alright, congratulations, you have finally achieved a very beautiful animation effect to amaze your audiences. If somehow your animation is not looking the same as mine, you can replay the video and see if you did some mistake while adding the effects since it is a little complicated. Also, you can refer this PPT file which I will be giving you in the description box below. If you still have any questions in your mind, you can post the same in the comment section below. One thing more, that this animation has a lot number of versatile options to try with. You can just experiment with some other effects, the timings of animations or the layout of the slide, and maybe you can achieve something better than this. And the major advantage of this animation technique is that it draws the attention of the audience towards your highlighted image and forces everyone to focus on your image. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.